Dear colleagues, I would like to take you to a field, an area which nobody truly understands in the world. This is quantum mechanics. Einstein is one of the founders of the quantum mechanics, and in my view, he was the greatest thinker in the 20th century. He didn't really understand quantum physics. Quantum mechanics is a science of probability, and Einstein said that God does not play games or roll dice and play like that. So, in spite of all this, basically it's a theory which could be then verified very exactly with experiments, which means that this is 10 on the minus 12 is the exactness that verified the quantum mechanics. And a few months before his death, Elemér Hankis, just next door, actually, I was holding a lecture on a completely different topic, and Elemér was following me as the next speaker. And Hankis talked about the social science implications of quantum mechanics. Obviously, some of his ideas or thoughts were not exact or correct, because listening to him, I felt that his thoughts and also had weak points. Although I'm quite knowledgeable of quantum mechanics, but I doesn't fully understand it. He gave me a plan for an article and a suggestion how quantum mechanics and quantum mechanical thinking could be adopted to social sciences. This was in English, this is what I gave, so basically this is what the text was, and I think you can also access this. So he just listed the topics which he collected for this. Then we sat down, had a talk, and we agreed that we should continue, but unfortunately we couldn't because of his death. So I believe that in an institute that actually took upon to care and cherish his heritage, we must not overlook quantum mechanics. So this is definitely just food for thought, and just to whet your appetite, how quantum mechanics could be used in social sciences. I'm not giving you explanations, but if you want me to later, maybe I can give you these explanations. The quantum world is a very strange world. There are many peculiarities about it, but basically it requires a completely different way of thinking if you want to find your way in this world. In the classical world is a deterministic world. We know at a given time, we know what are the relationship between cause and effect, and then make deductions from that. But quantum world is a probabilistic world. For example, when we know where the position of the particle, we can't actually give the velocity of this particle or vice versa. But in spite of this, actually, we can define and describe phenomena quite well with this. Quantum mechanics has three basic quantum phenomena, one being the duality of particles and waves. We actually used to the fact that light is a wave, an atom is a particle. But interestingly, also, light has wave or particle characteristics, and atom has wave characteristics. So at certain moment, one or the other comes to the foreground. The other is the tunneling effect, because we also got used to the fact that if there's a mountain and there's no tunnel, we just climb the mountain to get to the other side. But according to quantum mechanics, actually, there is a way to tunnel ourselves, so to say, unseen tunnels. So the particles carefully can climb or squeeze through these tunnels. This is what we call quantum effect. The third, which we call superposition and entanglement, which means that if you have a system or a particle, actually can exist in several states, and we don't know which one they are at or where they are at. If we could define their position, actually their quantum mechanical characteristics would be lost. For example, if you think about there's a box and there's a cat inside, we don't know whether the cat is alive or dead, 50% for both. And in order to find out, we have to open the box. The opening, the act of opening, is the measurement. This is the, when we're using a quantum mechanical measurement, actually we usually ruin the quantum mechanical characteristics. So that is how I try to illustrate how peculiar and important at the same time quantum mechanics is. Now, the photoelectric effect, this is what Einstein described, which shows that the photon, the light particle, basically, that has certain characteristics. So if light shines on the surface, then, for example, as the billiard balls hitting each other, then it just knocks or knocked from it. The tunneling effect on the other side, as I shown, climbing through rather than climbing across it. The third is the cat, which is half dead, half alive, until we open the box that the cat is in. So these phenomena, of course, are much less trivial. This was just for illustration, but these actually appear in our daily lives. And in physics, quantum mechanics has its basic characteristic. Whatever I touch, wherever area field I'm working in, it's a gold mine, because anything that we haven't noticed or detected before, we now see quantum mechanical phenomenon, and we can explain things with quantum mechanics that we couldn't explain before. And what we see endeavors in physics and mathematics now, actually, the quantum mechanics as a phenomena now can be used in IT. Just imagine you have the computer, and the effectiveness of this computer basically depends on the number of bits in the system that it uses. We started with 16 bits, then 32 bits, now we have the 64-bit computers that we're using, which again led to an increase in performance capacity. So if we double the bits, then also the performance doubles. In quantum mechanics, this actually is an exponential growth. So the number of bits basically is on the n power of n is how the it grows. So you could come up with computers in the future that are more effective, much more effective than current or efficient than current computers. At the moment, IBM actually working on the 50-bit of quantum, but they already using 50-bit quantum computers. They are not for sale. Basically, they using the computer time, selling the computer time instead of and the computer capacity rather than just the computers as hardware. And basically, this will be a reality in the near future. Let me move on. You would think that biology is definitely something that quantum mechanics has no role in. That's not true. This slide shows the photosynthesis. So from above, the photon from the sun beam comes in, then the electron is generated, and the electron actually travels through the molecule all the way, but we, or biologists, call to the reaction center. I don't really want to go into detail, but that's what happens. An electron, according to quantum mechanics, uses different pathways. That's what's actually described here, the three different arrows, the directions. So different pathways, and the length of these pathways are different. The waves actually reach the other side at different phases, and that causes interference. This is quantum interference, which has different and many, many consequences and effects. And in biology, also now we can see quantum mechanics. I mean, it was always there, but now we're aware of it. And we keep marveling, for example, how precisely birds can orientate. And they exactly know where to fly, and when the weather changes, they migrate all the way back or fly all the way back to their nest. The way they do this is actually they're using the magnetic field of the Earth, and in the brains of the birds, there's a special molecule who uses quantum mechanic processes. And it's again, our brain basically is a quantum mechanical system, and humans also use it. So we are also quantum mechanical systems, and in our decisions, again, can be based on quantum mechanics. It might sound strange or funny, but actually it's true, and it's been put down in books as well. For example, in our conscience, quantum consciousness. So politician, again, just I read this in this book, so if a politician is about to make a decision, it's a bad decision, then according to quantum mechanics, we have can have options to bring different decisions, and the person just chose the wrong probability at that time. That's why it was a wrong decision. Also, there's another explanation. If there's a survey, public survey, asking people about certain issues, that's similar to quantum mechanical measurements, which might then influence the decisions of these people later on. So basically, what I want to say is a message that without quantum mechanics, we can't really understand social sciences either. That is why I believe here in Kőszeg also we have to discuss this, especially if we want to cherish Hankisi's heritage. That is what I wanted to share with you. Obviously, I put it very in very simple terms, which have deeper connotations, definitely. But maybe I was successful in igniting your interest or curiosity, and if you come to me with questions, I'm happy to answer them. Thank you.